Channel. It's me, Brittany Bear Makeup here, and today's video is spicy. This makeup look right here, I'm gonna show you guys how I achieved it. It was inspired by the beautiful Kylie Jenner's Met Gala look. I loved her smoky eyeliner, and I kind of wanted to teach you guys how to get this look because it is popping, and I promise you, you're gonna look amazing in it. But before we jump into today's video, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel right here, click this big red button and subscribe. And also guys, turn on my post notifications so you are notified the next time I have another poppin' video on my channel. Let's go ahead and dive into today's video inspired by the beautiful Kylie Jenner. You are now rocking with Brittany, bitch. So I'm gonna go ahead and start by priming my eyelids. I'm going to be using a concealer for this. So I'm using my Tarte Shape Tape and I'm going to be applying just a little dab on both sides. I love coming to my studio and being creative and just doing these looks, and it's been a minute since I've done one, so I'm really excited for today's video. I think it's gonna be fun and we better look fly. So for today's look, I went ahead and picked up some items that are brand new launches. I wanted to show you guys some new products, kind of change it up. There are gonna be some repetitive ones, but there's also gonna be some really fun new ones that I'm excited to show you. So today I'm actually using a very inexpensive palette. This is an e.l.f. palette and it's Mad for Matte Summer Breeze palette. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off by grabbing a tiny little blending brush. This is a Sigma E45 brush and I'm gonna go into this really pretty light brown cool shade. So I'm gonna pop this color into the crease and I'm slightly drawing into the crease just a nice rounded sketch of where I want to kind of blend out that eyeshadow. So with that same brush, guys, I'm just going in and kind of cutting out that crease, and I'm really just kind of lightly buffing and blending it in while I'm doing that, just to give it a nice, beautiful, soft shape. So I'm spending a couple minutes just going back and forth and really just kind of blending that out. I'm gonna go in with a concealer and really cut the crease and kind of clean everything up. So for that, I'm gonna be grabbing a concealer brush. This is a Sigma F75 brush. And I'm gonna be going into one of my favorite concealers of all time. This is my Kevin Aucoin. This concealer is just next level, my friends. Now, what I'm gonna do with this is I'm gonna go ahead and cut the crease. So I'm gonna begin by packing the product onto the lid and creating kind of like a cut crease action right here. So just going into the corner, cutting it very sharp. You already know, bam, bam, bam. Look at that. Cutting the crease is also gonna make your eyelids look a lot bigger. I naturally have more hooded eyelids, so when I do this, I notice that it just photographs differently and it makes my eyelids have 10 times more space. So going back into that e.l.f. eyeshadow palette, I'm gonna go ahead and pick up another brush and I'm gonna be using this one right here. It is a Morphe E17 brush and I'm gonna go into this really pretty light bone shade and pack this on to my lid. So the key about this look that she has going on is that she makes it look really effortless, very simple, very clean. So we kind of want to recreate the same thing. We don't want it to look too harsh, like we have this serious cut crease action. We want it to look like we just woke up beautiful and we didn't even have to try. So I'm just packing this on and just kind of buffing it into that brown shade as well to give it more of that like flawless type of blend. Okay, so in the picture, Kylie has like this gorgeous, very beautiful, clean winged eyeliner. So we got to recreate that today. And I'm actually going to be trying out the Morphe eyeliner. So they just came out with these really cool like felt pens. I'm going to go ahead and pull my eye and I want to start with the wing right here. So I'm going to start by pulling upward with light strokes. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come to the end of the liner and I'm gonna drag it downward towards the bottom part of my lash line, just like that. It looks a little funky right now, but we're gonna clean it up. We're gonna make it look super straight and very sharp. So I'm tracing along the lower lash line, and honestly, this eyeliner is working just perfect because it's very thin at the tip. So it's doing its job and just really getting in there without making my eyeliner get thicker and thicker, because we all know that's a hot mess and that can definitely ruin our makeup. I feel like I'm really happy with how it looks and how it turned out. Super clean and fresh, which is exactly what I'm going for. All right guys, so for the shading, I'm gonna go in with a Sigma brush. This is an E15 brush, and I'm gonna go back into the e.l.f. palette and grab this charcoal black color right here. And then I'm gonna go in in, and I'm slightly just going to kind of add some shadow to the liner. Nothing crazy, but just almost make it look a bit more smoky in the corner. So very light pressure, just kind of making it look like it was a smoked out eyeliner. All right, guys, so this is what it looks like once I went ahead and I finished off both eyes. So the next step is going to be foundation. And I'm really excited for today because I'm gonna be showing you guys one of my new favorite foundations. So this is the Ciate London foundation. So what I love about this foundation on the back, I just saw this, it says it's cruelty-free. Thank you, I love that because I'm an animal lover myself. I love to see a foundation that works amazing, looks amazing, and also is not harming animals in the process. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my Joico sponge and I'm going to be applying this foundation all over my face. I'm gonna be tapping it in. I just love the coverage of it. I love how it goes on and it just feels hydrating and beautiful. I'm gonna go ahead and work this into my skin, make sure that I blend it out nicely all over because Kylie has that beautiful flawless finish. She always looks just like so airbrushed and perfect. We wanna recreate that type of vibe for today's makeup, so we're gonna try really hard, guys. Now that you can see the foundation, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. This foundation is really good if you have dry skin because it's more on the oily side and hydrating. That's definitely gonna be something for my dry skin girls out there who wanna look hydrated, who want that like sheer but yet fuller coverage. This is definitely gonna be your go-to foundation for the summer. Now that I've shown you that, I definitely wanna go in and I want to warm up my face. I'm gonna be using my Makeup Forever. This is my Ultra HD foundation, another one of my favorite foundations from back in the day. I feel like I haven't used this in so long. And I'm going to be contouring out my face just to kind of add warmth to it where it looks natural, not too cakey, and not too thick. So taking this foundation, I'm going on both sides of my cheekbones and just kind of adding it to that. The rim of my forehead as well. And then I like to kind of carve out my bottom half of my face. So then I'm gonna take my sponge and I'm just gonna blend this out. This is gonna give me that natural contour that I love. Just kind of melts into the skin because it is foundation, just like that. And then onto the other side as well. Now it's time for my concealer. And I showed you guys my Kevin Aucoin concealer when I did my eyes. This is my favorite concealer of all time. I love e.l.f., I love Tarte, I love so many Jouer. There's so many concealers that work. But there is no concealer like Kevin Aucoin. This is the holy grail, my friends. So I'm gonna grab this concealer and I'm gonna use this to conceal my under eyes. So I'm going in and I'm placing it exactly where I wanna conceal. A little bit of this product goes a very long way, so you definitely do not have to lather it in. It is just gonna do its job with just a little bit on my chin and then also the lower part of my forehead as well. Then I'm gonna go in, and this is my little mixture concoction. I'm gonna grab my Tarte Shape Tape. This is Fair Neutral, and I'm gonna go in and just kind of mix the two for brightness, the bridge of my nose, and then the sides. And just like that. Then taking my sponge once again, I'm gonna go in and I'm going to begin buffing this out. Look at that highlight, guys. Look at that coverage from Kevin Aucoin. Like, I am telling you, when I wanna look my best, I wear Kevin Aucoin. So I'm just packing the product in, making sure it's nice and blended. I am going to be using my Huda Beauty setting powder. I haven't used it in a minute, and this is the shade Cupcake. So Cupcake is like a lighter pink undertone. So taking that same Joico sponge, I'm gonna grab some powder, and right away, I'm gonna go in and I'm going to bake my under eyes and all the areas of my face that I basically have a lot of makeup on. So my lower jaw area, kind of like the reverse contouring areas, lower part of my forehead, as well as the rest of my forehead. I just kind of pack it everywhere, but I try to kind of sculpt out my face, give it a little bit more dimension, the bridge of my nose. So far, loving what we're doing, loving how it's turning out. All right, so I like to kind of set my nose and let it absorb because I'm gonna be contouring my nose off camera, but now that I'm on camera, we're gonna go ahead and contour. So taking my Hoola bronzer and my BH Cosmetics 3 brush, I'm gonna go in and just warm up my face with this shade and just give it some life because we are looking a bit cakey right now. So I'm gonna go in and kind of like re-sculpt out those nice cheekbones. Just like that. Already look more sculpted. And then on the other side as well, just kind of brushing it in. And then also the rim of my forehead once again, I'm just gonna take that powder down and just kind of, you know, make everything come to life. Gotta get that fake bronze action going on. All right, Bear Fam, so I'm gonna go off camera to contour my nose and do my eyebrows. And then when I come back, we're gonna finish off this Kylie Jenner kind of inspired Met Gala makeup look. So I'll see you guys in a second. It is time for the lashes. Today, I'm gonna be taking a really pretty wispy lash. This is from Morphe, and it is called Calabasas, which is so appropriate for today's look because Kylie lives in Calabasas. So we gotta bring them out, and we gotta put these bad boys on my eyes to finish the look. So I'm gonna place these bad boys on my lash line, just like that, okay. She came to laugh. She relevant again. On the other side as well. I am feeling myself. This Kylie Jenner inspired makeup is too fly. Now, one of the things to finish off the face is that Kylie always keeps her face more on the matte side, but she also uses like a really pretty soft pink blush to kind of give her that beautiful youthful look. So taking my NARS Orgasm blush, because it's one of my favorites, I'm gonna go ahead and apply this on my cheekbones to give myself kind of that similar soft and subtle pink glow that she always has. So I'm just applying it on the apples of my cheeks, just tapping it on, nothing too crazy. All right, so to finish off this look, we are going to finish it off with a really pretty nude lip. And for today, I'm gonna be using the ColourPop. This is a Shayla collab. I don't think it says the color name, but basically it's like a brown pencil. So I'm gonna be using this bad boy to outline my lips. And then what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be taking this lip gloss. This one is from Bobbi Brown, and it's actually a collaboration with Tenny. The color is called West Coast Bay. It's a really pretty like brown nude shade. I'm gonna be applying this on my lips. So pretty, very Kylie. All right, Bear Fam, so here is the final look. I am honestly feeling myself. I have not worn makeup like this in a really long time, and I haven't really done a makeup tutorial in a really long time this dramatic on my channel. So I hope you guys liked today's video. If you guys did, then don't forget to comment below and let me know what other Met Gala or other looks just in general that you guys want to see on my channel, because I'm feeling really makeup inspired lately. So comment down below. I want to give my huge post notification shout out to my girl, Marielle Franco. Thank you so much for having your post notifications on, girl. If you guys want a post notification shout out, all you guys have to do is turn them on and comment when done. Thanks for watching today's video. I love you guys, and I will see all of you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.